Hey there! Did you like the sequence that you saw? And I was inspired by Matrix movie when I was doing that. And basically the color grading was made in DaVinci Resolve, but the initial effect, the glitch thingy, was made in Premiere. And some of you DM'd me on Instagram like, hey, how we can do that glitch effect but without third-party plugins and without hassles inside the Premiere? And today I'm going to show you what you need to do in order to get that same effect. Let's jump into Premiere and I will show you how to do it. So I already imported our footage, and what we need to do next is we need to go to the effects tab and search for glitch and drag this VR glitch to our clip on our timeline. And what we need to do, so you can see already the glitch effect, but our issue here is that it's not moving and it's constant. So what we need to do, first thing, we need to track our phone here. So I'm going to track the phone, and for that we're going to use the mask. Something like this will do the trick. And let's track forward a couple of frames, and let's stop somewhere here. We can correct our tracking points, something like this. Track forward a bit and let's stop it somewhere there. And for the sake of this tutorial, I'm not going to be that much accurate. So you can see that our mask is tracked. And what we need, let's go back here somewhere. We don't need this effect whole time, so there is master amplitude, and keyframe this and set it to 0. So we're going to like choose a point, and actually let me show you one thing here. Let's go back to this key and I will show you. There is this distortion, and if we go there, and there is distortion rate, and if we lower this value to 0, you will see this RGB kind of split effect. And if you're looking for this, so you can go and like play with that, and you can set like keyframes for master amplitude. Like for example, you can see here, there is one keyframe that I need to remove. So you can see it is on 0 now, and you can go like a couple of frames forward using arrows on your keyboard, and you can keyframe there, and you can go to 100 and go like 2 frames more, go to 0 again, a couple of frames more, go to 100, a couple of frames more, go to 0, and you'll have kind of that RGB split effect. Let's take a look. Like you can see that. So, and there is more that you can do with your effect. For example, if we go and like bring back our distortion rate to our default value, you'll have this kind of effect. Like, and you can also animate this distortion by using this random seed, and you can keyframe that, and let's go with random numbers here and there. So you can see it is animating itself, like something like so. So you can play with these parameters and take a look what you want to achieve. So you can even go with these color evolution, and if we go down with this one, so you can see distortion complexity, and let's play with the color evolution. You're going to see that our footage is switching. Like the RGB effect is switching here and there, and you can play also with that. Or You can just go and remove everything, remove the mask. So I removed the mask, and you can see now our effect is on our whole clip, and we can use again the master amplitude and go to zero, go a couple of frames forward, go to 100, couple of frames more, go to zero, and do this kind of thing here, and couple frames more and go to zero, and we will have this thing here. Like, can you see that? Let me just zoom in here, and we can see that everything now is in RGB kind of glitch. And also you can play with the color evolution here, so it will shift your RGB distortion. And also you can play with the distortion complexity, so it will have this kind of effect. So let me show you. So let me go back here a bit, and you will have that kind of effect. Or you can again like use the random seed and keyframe it, and to have a random kind of values for distortion. And let us see what we have. So, and basically this is it for today's tutorial. Shit, message from work, and I need to get back to reality. Yep, reality is like that, you know. You have to have another job to afford a camera to record this YouTube video. I know, that's disappointing. Anyway, I hope you like this video, and if yes, please put a thumbs up. It will help a ton. Sub to the channel, and I will see you in the next video. Till then, bye-bye. Did you notice that everybody's going crazy with that new iPhones? And I'm still rocking with my OnePlus 6, and I'm happy. And if I had money for iPhone 13, I'd rather buy a lens for my Fuji. Till the next time, bye-bye.